In this video, I am going to explain basic anatomy of ligament of knee joint. Yes, knee joint ligament is very, very complicated, but these are very important. You see these kind of a yellowish structure? These are ligament, or part of this is tendon. So let's look at the biggest one, this one. This is not ligament. This is a tendon of muscle. Tendon of quadriceps muscle. By the way, you see this, the white one? This is patella, right? It's in front of knee joint. This is patella. This is tendon of quadriceps. And oftentimes, this part is called patella ligament. So easy. Patella, the tendon of quadriceps. Let's go to the medial side. By the way, this is medial side. It looks very big, very thick ligament. Remember, this is medial side. Medial side. And what's this? This is medial collateral ligament. Medial collateral ligament. You might have had this injury, MCL rupture or MCL injury. This ligament is very often in the sports injury. Let's go to the other one. This is lateral side. We just looked MCL, medial collateral ligament. This is lateral side. So what is this? This is lateral collateral ligament, LCL. And in the 2013, the new ligament was discovered. This one, this beige tape one, this is anterolateral ligament. This anterolateral ligament is very close to LCL. This looks diagonal, but direction varies, depends on people. Maybe somebody's anterolateral ligament runs like this, vertically, or like in this model, it runs like a little bit diagonally. It depends on the people. However, we have this ligament, anterolateral ligament. LCL, anterolateral ligament. And let's go to medial side. Let's go to medial side. This is MCL. Let's compare the size of MCL and LCL. Which one looks bigger? Which one looks thicker? That's MCL, right? Because of biomechanics of our body, the medial side of knee joint takes more stress compared to lateral side. So medial side of the knee joint gets more injury. Why? Because this takes more stress compared to lateral side. Speaking of medial collateral ligament, I have to talk about this blue structure. What is this? Let's go to closer view. This is meniscus. We have meniscus in knee. What is meniscus? Meniscus is like a shock absorbing system of knee. You know, we walk, we run, we jump, we play sports. On the knee joint, it has to take a lot of stress. So if meniscus doesn't exist, this bone and bone contact is direct. That means you may have more chance to get injury, right? So meniscus is very important to reduce stress. Then medial collateral ligament. And medial meniscus and medial collateral ligament get more chance to get injury compared to lateral meniscus, lateral collateral ligament. Why? Because I just said medial part takes more stress than lateral side. Anyway, medial meniscus, lateral meniscus. And let's go to closer view. You see the beige tape between medial meniscus and lateral meniscus? This ligament which connects meniscus. So this is transverse ligament. What's transverse? Transverse is this direction. So transverse ligament connects medial meniscus and lateral meniscus. It runs like this way. That's why this is transverse ligament. Review. MCL, LCL, anterolateral ligament, and the tendon of quadriceps, patella ligament, and transverse ligament. Let's go to the posterior view. By the way, I uploaded a very specific anatomy of backside of the knee joint, so please check if you want to know. So this is posterior view. This is lateral side, this is medial side. You see the MCL and LCL. Lateral meniscus, medial meniscus. I want to talk about this ligament. This ligament connects lateral meniscus and femur. So this is meniscofemoral ligament. Meniscofemoral ligament. And you see very, very deep ligament here. This is anterior cruciate ligament. Very famous one. This is ACL. If we have ACL, we should have posterior cruciate ligament, which is PCL. What is it? So this is PCL. I want to talk about relationship in ACL and PCL. In this model, it's very hard to see ACL and PCL 3D. So let's imagine this red pen is ACL. ACL runs like this direction, this direction. And PCL runs like this direction. So ACL and PCL like this. This is just example. ACL, PCL. So they kind of cross. That's why this is anterior cruciate ligament. This is posterior cruciate ligament. But in reality, is there more easy ways to remember the relationship between ACL and PCL? Let's see. So you are looking knee joint from anterior, and this is the lower part. This is upper part. This is medial part. This is lateral part. So this is right knee. So what is easy way to remember ACL and PCL? So that's crossing finger. Let's say my middle finger is ACL. My index finger is PCL. So they run like this. ACL runs anteriorly and go this way, this way. PCL, more like this way, kind of perpendicular, but still has angle. ACL cross like this, my middle finger. PCL, the index finger, like this. So this is right knee joint. So I use right hand, cross finger like this. So if this is left knee, if this is left knee, that's gonna be like this. Middle finger ACL, index finger PCL, like this. This is my left hand, this. This is right knee. My right hand, cross finger, my right middle finger ACL, index finger PCL. So this helps a lot to remember the relationship of ACL and PCL. So let's go to review again. So we have tendon of quadriceps, patella tendon, patella. We have MCL right here, big ligament. This is very strong ligament. Go to the lateral view, lateral view. This is LCL, lateral collateral ligament. This is anterolateral ligament. This ligament was found in 2013. Very new ligament. And you see the ligament, this one, this is transverse ligament, which connects what? Lateral meniscus and medial meniscus, that one. What is meniscus? Meniscus is like a shock absorbing system of knee joint. You remember that? And let's go to the posterior view. What is this one? This is meniscofemoral ligament. This is PCL, posterior cruciate ligament. Deep to PCL, this is ACL. What was easy way to remember the ACL-PCL relationship? This is right knee, use my right hand, cross finger. So that's it. You know, ligamental system of knee joint is very, very important. Why? Because you see the structure of knee joint. This is tibia. This is femur. Femur just sits on the tibia. You know, it's not like hip joint. Hip joint is like a ball and socket joint, right? Hip joint is very stabilized because of this bony structure. The ball fits on the socket. But look at knee joint. The femur just sits on the tibia. It looks very unstable. To stabilize joint, what do we need? Ligaments. So balance of ligaments or tension of ligaments or injury of ligaments give big impact for knee joint. So that's why ACL injury or MCL injury or other knee ligament injury can have big impact for knee joint. So in this video, I explained basic anatomy of knee joint. I know it is very complicated, but I hope this video helps your understanding of knee ligament. If you liked today's video, please like, comment, and subscribe. See you in next video.